Static friction is an application of external equilibrium. Frequently covered in statics, so force from static friction, or F sub x, is equal to mu sub s times n, where mu sub s is the coefficient of static friction. And n is the normal force. We can basically use this relationship to solve several different types of external equilibrium problems. So, one problem. I have a box, and it's on an angle. When the angle is increased to 45 degrees, the box starts to slide. What is the coefficient of static friction? So, this box has a mass. It's also on Earth. So we know that the box has a weight, and weight always acts down. Now, static friction always acts parallel to the surface. So here we have F sub s, and it acts parallel to the surface. We also have a normal force, and normal is another way of saying we have a force acting at 90 degrees. And I want to know what my coefficient of static friction is. Now, we can do this by using our equations of equilibrium. So, if this angle is 45 degrees, we know that the weight is acting down at an angle of 45 degrees, but I think the easiest thing to do here is to create ourselves a nice coordinate system. And we're going to simplify the problem by saying, all right, let's have an origin right here at the middle. Our y-axis is going to go this way, and our x-axis is going to go this way. By orienting our coordinate system like this, we've now put normal force acting positive along our y-axis and our static force acting negative along our x-axis. So we don't have to deal with as many trigonometric functions. We just need to resolve the W force into two components in the X and Y. Since the angle is 45 degrees, both angles here will also be 45 degrees. So if I sum my forces in the Y, they have to equal zero. Zero is going to equal Fn is acting positive, so we'll have Fn, or the normal force. According to our coordinate system, W cosine of 45 will be acting negative in our y direction, so it'll be minus W cosine of 45. If we solve this, we find that Fn has to equal W cosine of 45. If we sum forces in the X, they have to equal zero. Zero is going to equal minus the force of static friction because it's acting in the negative direction, plus W cosine of 45. And this helps us find out that F of S equals W cosine 45. And then we need to go back to our original relationship, knowing that the static force is equal to mu sub s times the normal force. We know what the normal force is. It's w cosine of 45. We know what the static force is, w cosine of 45. So we can go back and make the substitution. Force static is w cosine 45 equal to mu sub s, thing we're looking for. Our normal force, we called it force sub n, sorry, in this problem, is equal to mu sub s times w cosine 45. We divide both sides by w cosine 45. We find that the coefficient of static friction is equal to 1. So to solve this problem of the sliding things, we used our two equations of equilibrium, sum of forces in the x, sum of forces in the y, and we determined what our coefficient of static friction is. Okay, there are lots of other fun static friction problems. Let's say we have a box that weighs 100 pounds. It is 8 feet tall. It is 2 feet wide. And we want to push the box. But we don't know what force we want to use, and we don't know what height we're going to put that force at. And I want to know what force is required to move the box, and how high can it be applied. We know that the coefficient of static friction between the surface and the box, mu sub s, is equal to 0.45. So we know that since we have a box, the ground is flat. We know that in order for this to be in equilibrium in the y direction, there has to be a normal force acting up, S sub n. If we sum the forces in the y, they have to equal 0. 0 is going to equal minus 100 because it's a weight, plus F sub n. We know that F sub n equals 100 pounds. Now, we know that if we want to slide the box, the force we apply has to exceed the force from static friction. So we know that if we sum the forces in the x, they're not going to equal 0 this time. We want them to equal, or we want the force to be greater than F sub s. So our force is going to have to be greater than F sub s is defined as mu sub s times the normal force. This force has to be greater than 0.45 times 100. So our force must be greater than 45 pounds. Now, how high up on the box can we push? Now, here's the thing. Force from static friction is acting on the ground. The force that is pushing is acting some distance above the ground. When we have forces and distances, we create moments. Now, what is actually happening is the normal force from the 100 pounds is not acting directly up from the center. In order for this to be in equilibrium, F sub n actually has to be acting some distance away from the center so that it creates a moment to cancel out the height, the moment caused by pushing the force at the height. So in order to find out how high we can possibly push, we need to make sure that all the moments are equal to 0. So if the sum of the moments equals 0, 0 will have to equal F times h. I'm going to call this distance that we've defined here x. So sum of the forces has to equal 0. We have fh minus 100 times x. Now, x is a variable, but we are limited to what x can be. So x can only, the force can only exist underneath the box. So if the weight is acting from the center of mass in the middle, at a maximum, x can only be equal to 1. Because if it were equal to 2, the force would be out here, and there's no way for that force to exist. So the maximum height will come when x equals 1. So we can say that f times h has to equal 100 times 1. If we know that our force is 45, we find that our maximum height we can push at is 2.22 feet. But again, static friction is basically just an application of our equilibrium forces internally. While this one is greater, this is basically an application of some of the forces.